This is an Agile and ESOF EDA web demo on cosimulation with layout components. Layout components is a new concept that lowers the barriers between the electrical and physical analysis domains. Their layout look-alike symbols facilitate a visually intuitive EM circuit cosimulation with schematic components in the ADS schematic environment. Layout components are automatically generated in the ADS layout environment after the layout and ports are defined. The result is a scaled version of the layout artwork and is made accessible from the ADS schematic. The process for producing layout components is straightforward. Layout artwork can be imported into the ADS layout environment using standard translators like GDS2, DXF, or IGES, or it can be entered by the user. Once the layout artwork is complete and ports assigned, layout components are generated by a click of a button. Let's walk through it. The layout component feature is accessible from ADS layout under the Momentum menu. To launch the layout component dialog box, click here. This is the main dialog box for defining the layout component's parameters, such as symbol type, model base, and database options. For this example, we'll choose the layout look-alike symbol type for the layout component we want to generate. This feature will give us a visually intuitive layout symbol to use in the schematic. Next, we need to define the symbol size. The layout component symbol size can be defined by one of three options: minimum pin-to-pin distance, maximum pin-to-pin distance, and layout unit scaling to schematic units. For this example, we will choose to scale the symbol by defining the minimum pin-to-pin distance to equal one schematic unit. This method is recommended when the layout component to be generated will encompass other schematic components like resistors and capacitors. Next, we will define the modeling parameters, such as choosing the EM simulation engine, substrate information, frequency plan, and mesh density. Since the physical dimensions of the design are small relative to the wavelength of the frequency of operation, we will select the Momentum RF simulation engine, which will significantly reduce the simulation time. Next, the substrate information can be edited, as well as the frequency plan and key mesh parameters. The layout component's database is where the generated models are stored. Database handling is possible after the layout component is generated. Once the above parameters are defined, then click OK. The layout component has now been generated. At this point, the generated layout component is accessible from the ADS component library in the schematic. Layout components are accessed from the ADS library, and they appear under the appropriate project in the subnetworks directory. To place on a schematic, simply click and drag. Layout components are used in the schematic just like other components and can be connected to any other schematic element that has pins. Note that the assigned ports in the layout translate to the pins in the schematic. Now let's start adding discrete elements to this layout component so we can perform an EM circuit cosimulation. At this point, we've finished attaching the desired discrete components, including passive as well as active elements. Next, let's add simulation ports and control blocks. Notice when we initiated the simulation, the Momentum simulation engine was invoked to analyze the layout component and establish a model for it. This EM model will then be stored in the component's database for future use. Once the Momentum simulation is done, an S-parameter circuit simulation is performed on the rest of the circuit. And once the co-simulation is complete, design results are available for analysis and display in the ADS data display. Layout components provide transparent integration of electromagnetic simulation using layout look-alike symbols at the schematic design level, and seamless and intuitive EM circuit co-simulation from a circuit schematic. For more information on co-simulation with layout components, please visit the webpage listed here. Thank you for watching this Agile and ESOF EDA demo, and I hope you're successful using co-simulation with layout components in the future.